Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight I'm going to explain to you what the illegal argument exception is. So if you are an experienced Java developer who already know this, then skip this. This video will not be for you. But if you are a beginner and you're a bit uncertain when should I use the illegal argument exception and what is it, then this is the video for you, of course, and then just hang on. It has existed forever. It helps us to fail fast, which we want to, because then we can also improve our application fast, and then we can develop very fast. So, and it is an unchecked exception. That means that we are not surrounding it with a try-catch. We are not trying to catch it. If we experience an illegal argument exception, then we did something wrong. We used the method, the library where we are trying to use. We used that in a wrong way with some arguments that was not intended to use. And the most often used case is when we try to pass null to a method that actually cannot use null. So let us try to create an example right here. I'm using IntelliJ. I pressed File, New Project. I chose Java. I'm using SDK 14 right now. Next, finish. And then I ended up with this project right here. And now I'm creating a new Java class. So this is Alien Verifier Test. Oh, demo, let us call that. So now I have an Alien Verifier demo. And now I have a main. And I want to create a public, it could also be static, void, not void. I want to create an alien. I haven't created the alien class yet, so I need to do that. And then I want to create alien like this. And I will get a name, string name. Then I'll get a float height and a float weight like this. Could also be doubles, of course, but it doesn't matter. So I need to create the alien. Let us create that class, create class alien. Destination package, yes, no package. And private final string name, private final string under string float height, private final float weight. So this is the alien, and the reason why I used private final, because then I can just write add constructor parameters, and then I can just mark all three of them like this. I'm not using Lombok to this example, so that means it is just vanilla Java. And here we have a constructor where I create this. I would also like to create, do I need to get us? Now I would like to create it to string. Let us create a good to string. So I'll go up here, alt inserts to string. Yes, give me a good to string. And then I can create my alien right here. And now I would like to create some checks. So I will say if height equals null or weight equals null or name equals null, then throw new illegal argument exception like this. Stuff now into this method. Of course, we could also have made it per argument if that's what we want to write. So then we want to check if height, if that is less than, we can say just say it's a centimeters. Let's say that it was centimeters that we got. Let's say that it's less than 30, then we know it's an error, it's not valid. Then we can throw an exception, throw new legal argument exception. Aliens must be at least 30 centimeters high, like this. And yes, I'm using the metric system. I am from Denmark. So if weight is less than, and this time it's kilogram, if there's less than 20 kilograms, then we say must weigh at least 20 kilograms, like this. If not, then we can actually return a new alien like this. Return a new alien and everything is good. Return name, height, weight, like this. And everybody is happy. So let us try here. I'll create a new alien. I want to system out print line my alien. So I'll say create alien like this. And then I'll say give it a name, Mike. Yes. Height, to begin with, I'll just give it 20. And the weight, I'll give that 10. And it's not a string, of course, it's a float. So All right, like this, and I'll run my program, and I think everything is going fine. I'm very happy. I just finished my code just before the end of the day. Everything is good, but no, now I get an illegal argument exception. Because someone was so nice to create this illegal argument exception, then this error that I created right here, it did not go into production. It could actually be found at compile time. Oh, sorry, runtime. It is runtime, but we found it in our test, of course. So we did not. It was not something that would trigger some side effects further down in the program. I know right away. I can click this button right here. Then there's the link right there. Then it says line 13, and I can see that it's because need to be at least 30 centimeters high. And I can press this other line here in the stack trace. And then I can go and actually set the height to 40 maybe. Obviously, oh, that was a huge mistake. It should have been 45. And the weight, let us just keep that at 10 right now because I would like to get another illegal argument exception. And that is exactly what I get. Aliens must at least weigh 20 kilos. I can click right there. I can see this line right here. End up in, and I can click one step down. Then I end up where I actually call the method. So let us give it a real weight instead. And let us run the program and see what actually happens. And now I get this beautiful alien right here. And 45 centimeters, of course, is not good. Let us write something else like this. And instead of Mike, then I would actually like to try to just write null like this. Oh, don't stuff null into this method. Yes, no, I won't. Then I'll try with an empty string right now, because that is actually okay. Like this. So now I'm trying with an empty string. That is not very good, because empty strings are not that handy. Look, we have an alien with the name empty string. That is not good. Let us create a new check. We can create as many check, of course, as we feel like. Name.length must be above, maybe 3 characters or 4 characters. Yeah, 3 characters. It's okay with 3 characters. I guess there are some, there are a lot of short names, so it must be one or more characters, right? Let us try that. Throw new illegal argument, and now I can see I just turned the condition upside down, so the string is empty. I could also ask if the string is empty, because then I don't need to, I should actually have written if it's less than 1. I could also say less, less than 1. But we can also say is empty. There's a method for that. Is blank, that's also a blank. That checks for a lot of cool things, actually. Let us just look at that. Is blank. So we got index of non-white spaces, so is equals to length. So that means that then it doesn't count the white spaces. That is pretty cool. Let us use that. That's a good method. Let us run our program again and see what I can actually create some white spaces now. Let us see what happens now. Oh, now I get an error. The string is empty. Yes, because we only have blanks inside the string. I'll just write something, and then our program is good again. Now it works without any illegal argument exception. Thank you very much for watching. That's it. I'll commit and push the code as usual and send it to GitHub, and you can just get it if you like it, of course. I hope to see you again soon, and have a great evening. Bye bye.